Don't you can disagree with somebody, or you don't have to like that person, but you don't have to treat them vile and disgusting and any of that. You don't have to do that. You guys are better than that. I know for a fact you guys are so much better than that. Oh, auntie, oh. All right. Could cost zero to keep your mouth shut and be kind. 100%. Straight facts. Anyway, new subject. New subject. Do I have any mods in here, y'all? Mods, are you in here? No, mods, are you in here? Mods? All right. Hey Lou, if you want to start yeah, Karen, I'm gonna go ahead. If you guys want to start blocking these negative people, please, that'd be great. Oh, sorry, Karen, I just unmuted you. Whoops. And moderator. Mods, if we can start blocking these people, please. Thanks, mods. Thank you. Thank you. I don't need no mods. No, I'm good. I would just mute them. Let them watch. Let them watch. Just go ahead and just start muting them for me, guys. Just mute them. Don't block them. Just mute them. Just mute them. Let them watch. Dang, that watch is a bling. Bling? No, that's not a bling bling. What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? All right. Thank you, mods. Can I ask you a funny question to think about something else? Go for it. Go for it. Hey, chat, we're not gonna pay attention to the rude comments. That my mods are taking care of it. Let my mods handle it. Let my mods handle it. Focus on the positivity. Focus on me, not the chat. Focus on me, not the chat. All right? Okay. Anyway, what did everybody do today? Did you work? Did you eat dinner? What'd you do? Let's just change the subject around. Let's just change it. Here we go. Well, what'd you guys do today? Let's talk about something positive. How was your day? You worked? You felt like poop? That's not good. Do you think hummingbirds have diabetes from all the sugar water humans feed them? What? I didn't get that. I found out I'm having neck surgery that I've been waiting for a year for. Really? Well, I really hope you have a speedy recovery on that, and I'll keep you in my prayers, love. Our school. Wait, hold on. Our school just shut down in GA for the next 2 days. What? Really? Dang. Yeah, I've been hearing a lot of schools are getting shut down. Work now getting ready to make dinner, even though I want Chinese. Dude, Chinese sounds so good. I'm not gonna lie, bro. I'm not gonna lie, bro. Sounds so good. Work now getting ready to make dinner, even though I want you. Oh, yeah, I already heard that. I got my hair done. Ooh, you probably feeling good and fresh, right? I love when you get a haircut. Slept all day? Lucky you. You're cleaning and cooking? Okay, all right. My son has walking pneumonia. No, Kelsey, I'm so sorry about that. I have no idea who this person is. What's up, Becca? How are you, love? Are you gonna be safe with a storm? Are you all prepared? For the most part, yeah. Hello? 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 The person in the box, hello? Okay. Have a good day. I guess you didn't want to come up here. Goodbye. I'm relaxing and chilling since I'm done working. I know. Doesn't it feel so good when you come home, guys, and you're just like, oh my God, you lay in the bed and you're like, yes, this is the best feeling ever. Do you think sand is called sand because it's in between the sea and the land? What? Wait, what? What? Maybe they requested by accident. They probably did. They probably did. I'm not gonna lie. Do you have to board up your windows? No, I don't think so. We can watch the news. I mean, I don't really see anything though. It's literally my favorite time of the day. Is it? Why? What's your favorite time of the day? My kid had gymnastics tonight, so it's making easy dinner. Oh, well, have fun with them. Why do seagulls fly over the sea? I have no idea why. I really want to know this question, though. Relaxing in my bed. Yeah. Oh, you're sick. I'm so sorry about that. Hope you feel better. Getting in bed and getting in a sleep coma. It's the best, bro. I love it. I don't get to lay in bed till my kid's in bed. Well, you will eventually. What's up, Charlotte? I'm good, love. How are you doing? Did you hear Claire Annette play the clarinet? What? Is that supposed to be a joke? Because if they flew over the bay, they would be beagles. Beagles? That was a good one. Oh, that was a good one. Oh, what's up, Alex? How are you, love? I might do shopping while she's at gymnastics. Well, you should. I'm doing. How's the weather there? It's raining. Let's take a look. I don't think it's that bad though. Let's take a look. Nothing really too bad. Here, maybe I can show you guys. All right. I don't know if you guys can see, but there's like. It's fine now. You can see, like, it's a little bit. Not really. I mean, you can see the dark. But it's not too bad. It's not too bad. It's not too bad. For right now, it's not too bad. I think what's really going to happen is I think that by tomorrow, it's going to get really, really bad. So, I don't really know. I haven't really. Expect. Girl, they're saying could be a category of 3 or 4. It's worse in Georgia. Well, please be safe wherever you guys are at. Let's turn the weather on. You want to turn the. Okay, fine. We'll turn the weather on. Come on. There's nothing else to do. I'm bored. I got nothing else to do. All right, hold on. I'm sorry. I'm right here. We can watch the weather together. Weather with the weather. Weather. Oh, did I probably didn't get it. Wait, live TV. Okay, here we go. It's already at category 1. If it shifts, you'll be in the eye.
Hitting hard, hitting fast, and moving a lot out, but the damage will be done because of those wind gusts. In excess of 100 miles an
hour. Here's Keaton Beach, Florida.
I wouldn't be surprised if virtually everybody loses power.
Storm surge flooding could reach 18 feet.
7 to 9 days.
Category 1, wind 80 miles per hour.
And knocked out a lot of trees. So,
Florida landfall in less than 30 hours. St. Pete Beach, Florida. And Keaton Beach. Keaton, Keaton Beach, Florida.
That's all you can do, right? Right, Mike? I mean,
widespread, long-lasting power outage likely. Where's St. Pete Beach? Helena. Wait, where's that at?
So folks should be preparing for impacts like that. That's Fox Weather Storm Specialist Mike Seidel. Thanks. Continuing coverage of Hurricane Helene continual. That'll be right here on Fox. Well, this is a 24/7 thing from now.
Oh, there's Fort Myers. Look at this.
We've got big impacts.
There's Fort Myers.
Closer to the landfall location.
What does that mean?
And the fast forward speed. We've got problems across a big chunk of the southeast. Navarre Beach on the right side. You've got Hudson.
I don't get it. Help me!
Some of those bands moving on through. This is the very beginnings of Hurricane Helene, expected to rapidly intensify tonight. Keep it right here on Fox Weather. We'll be right back.
Wait!
We now have Hurricane Helene. The worst of this storm is likely yet to come.
Wait, why is it saying Fort Myers, though?
A very dangerous, perhaps deadly scenario.
With each rain band, it gets more...
Mostly rain and wind, I'd say.
There's a lot of atmospheric energy. This is just what we...
It can shift.
That's the big wind, the big rain, and the rain...
We're not in the direct path. You'll get the rain bands.
Fox Weather, your hurricane.
No, I'm, yeah, I am in Fort Myers. That's where I'm at. Because you're close to the eye.
And now because of Florida's extreme abortion.
Well, I know the Cape Coral Bridge is closing. I do know that. Charge all your devices.
And could send doctors like me to prison.
Well,
that's terrifying. And it's why I'm voting yes on four.
I don't know. Well, I mean, we'll have to see because I got so many. Hold on. Battery banks.
Raise awareness for your new store opening. Drive consumers to your website and increase sales. With access to premium.
All right, I think I have a battery bank in my car, but I'm not 100% sure. I have my iPad charge as well.
Sign up for free today.
But I can because I mean that's only has that only has Wi-Fi, so. When is this happening? I got two different answers. Charge everything. Oh, I will.
Within 3 months, my hair was fuller.
It's longer. It's so much thicker.
I had more scalp coverage.
It's so nice to be noticed for my hair after.
Guys, listen. If I do lose power, I won't be able. Nobody will be able to get a hold of me. I don't know how long we're going to be out of power. I have no idea. We have no generators, no nothing. So, yeah. So, just, I mean, I think we'll be fine. I mean, like the most, like the thing is we probably will lose power, but that's pretty much all we're going to, I mean, I'm really not going to like be completely scared, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, I'm just gonna just go with the flow. Charge your stuff up now. All right, hold on. Let me go out to my car and grab myself a battery bank. Oh, hold on, they're here, hold on.
Welcome back to Fox Weather, your Hurricane HQ. This is...
So look at this. So explain this to me. I don't know why there's a cigarette butt there, but don't worry about that. Okay. Fort Myers, what is that? Okay, so there's... Okay, well, that's not helping. I don't know why my dresser is this way, but whatever. Don't look at it. I don't know. Look at my dresser. I don't know. Don't ask me. Okay, anyway, I got to clean up. Red is bad. Oh, we can watch this together. I have really got... Okay, what is this? It's rain band, pretty heavy. Well, this is gonna be lovely. Lovely. I'm gonna shut my doors. Like, why is my drawers like that open? Whatever.
Right here to the coastline. We can see some big gusts finding their way all the way across the peninsula. So, Jane, I know we're waiting on the new update from the National Hurricane Center. What's it look like on on satellite, you'd have to think that we have a stronger Helene. Heart counters are in there, too.
Yeah, I mean, we'll see what happens with the new update that's going to be coming in about the next 15 minutes or so. I mean, some of that dry air is trying to push its way in, but it looks like it's getting buffed out, and that deep thunderstorm development is still starting to take over. But
we are right in the path in Georgia. You will get strong winds, heavy wind, and probably flooding.
Deep thunderstorm development on the northern end of those outer bands, too. That's going to continue.
That's great. That's cool.
Incredibly warm waters. And with that, over the next 12, 15 hours, this is where we're really going to see that intensification begin to take place. But the field itself, you're already seeing these outer rain bands not only push up through the peninsula, Ian, you've already felt the impact of that, but the cloud shield was impressive to see how this has been venting.
I am off tomorrow. Yeah, I'm not working tomorrow.
A couple of hours since it became a hurricane.
I have to work Friday and Saturday, but I don't have to work tomorrow. Unless they tell us, so like they'll let us know by tomorrow if we are even working Friday. So I don't even know if we are. But for right now, everyone's off.
As we await on the new update from the National Hurricane Center coming up sometime right around the top of the hour, let's talk about the storm surge. This is a crisis in fact in this metro area, Tampa, St. Pete, down to Sarasota.
By all the tacos. Oh, there's Tampa right now.
In this country, to storm surge. That's especially the case post-pandemic.
But you know what? I did. So I talked to somebody today at work, and they said that this is what Ian did, and then Ian switched, and it came right to Fort Myers, and it trashed the whole entire beaches and everything. So that's what they were telling me at work today, that this is exactly what happened with Ian, and then Ian went completely, like, it shifted. So I don't really know. That's what I got told today. But 50 to 60 miles per hour we're getting. 50 to 60 miles per hour winds. Holy crap. We should go and buy a diamond art. No, that's a waste of money. I have other things that I need to put away. I don't want, no, that's just money I don't need to spend.
The shipping channels that are dredged big time to 50 or 60 feet.
So up to 18 feet, they're saying, for rain.
They stay in the channel for obvious reasons. Outside of that, there isn't a lot of water.
All right, hold on.
And you've got two inner bays.
I will, hold on.
Pockets in Hillsborough Bay and Old Tampa Bay. That's what we're looking at here, the forecast from the National Hurricane Center. It's up to 8 feet, cool. Which would exceed some of the records.
All right, I'll be right back. I'm going to go grab my power bank. I'll be right back. Stay there. Stay. I'll be right back. Stay.
Off the Nature Coast, and then especially into the Big Bend region of Florida, which I talked about Tampa Bay. I say Tampa Bay. It was Tampa Bay for a while. When I was living down here, two cups in a Super Bowl, you've got the Big Bend, which is shaped just like that, a bend that can catch all of that water, Jane. And that's where we could see an extreme surge. And that would be an unsurvivable surge in coastal areas of up to about 15 feet. And that's what you're seeing with some of these projections. Jane?
Yeah, I can't even imagine. I mean, we're talking, a storm that nobody has seen in, their lifetime. Well, when you see the potential of this.
No frame of reference.
No frame of reference. Yeah. And so that's a very real danger. And I think I'm sure there's a lot of pause to be done with that. And so, preparations, they're happening and they're finishing up through the day today. Ian, let's talk about what's going to happen with this storm after landfall and even ahead of landfall. Because the thing is, this is such a big storm that we're going to be feeling those tropical storm force winds, torrential rain, even before landfall happens, and certainly thereafter. We're highlighting a place like Atlanta. Over the next 3 days, we're already dealing with heavy rain training its way through this afternoon. That's going to continue tonight, but then it picks up as Helene gets closer to landfall, continues to push its way in at a quick pace.
No, I'll get that done.
Impacts both inland and unfortunately the terrain that we're seeing across all of Georgia.
I'll get it done.
For risk for flooding.
All right.
Into the mountains, Asheville,
is it charging?
Carolina, Franklin, and then down
is it charging?
Georgia, including Gainesville,
along portions. Yes, it is. Battery bank is charged.
And I think flooding is going to be a very real danger as we go through the next 24, 36 hours on into Friday afternoon across the Atlanta metro area, North Georgia, South Carolina as a whole. So this is going into midnight tonight. You can see that cold front's been hanging around with some of that heavier rain, but here comes that push of that tropical moisture from Helene, and Helene itself is moving at such a fast pace.
Not you, Danny. Wait, what did I do? Do you have an umbrella in case you get rain? No. I'll just go out there. It's not going to hurt you. It's rain.
If not hundreds of thousands, we could see millions of power outages across this region when we look ahead into the next couple of days. Flooding rain, and flooding rain is just one component to this. A lot of this felt up across North Georgia into the mountains where we could see up to a foot of rain or more fall. This is going to be taking us through the next 48 hours, but also to that severe weather risk. We could see several tornadoes out of those outer rain bands that are far reaching from the center of this storm itself. And so that's the danger in this, too. I mean, the southeast, it is very densely populated with trees, and the danger is that you won't be able to see that coming should that really come to fruition. So just prepare for those impacts as we see that rain continue to fall now. Fox Weather Hurricane HQ, and as we approach Helene's landfall, Fox Weather correspondent Robert Ray is in Steinhatchee, Florida, working with his team to prepare and find the best location for his exclusive hurricane coverage. Take a listen.
We are scouting locations all over the Big Bend, the Nature Coast, and this is Steinhatchee, Florida, the area prone to storm surge.
Danny, hurricane's water brings all kinds of yuck in. That's why they say I have bleaching chlorox wipes.
So you see how far that water, that was 10 to 15 feet. And, you know, we're just checking out all these.
Well, y'all stay safe out there.
We are safe during this recording that will begin for us during landfall Thursday.
Did you gas up your car? Yeah, I did.
Into Friday, and it's very strategic. You see the Fox Weather Beast. We got to keep our vehicles on high ground. And notice I'm walking up into higher ground. And Lloyd Alford behind the camera right now. Come with me. And I want to talk to our field producer and meteorologist, Jared Maloney, who has his brain and his eyes in all of the forecast models as we continue to
look
for location.
Hi.
Jared, this area, your first thoughts about potentially reporting here tomorrow night?
You know, with the track, the way it's looking to be, we're not going to get the peak surge here, but
we don't want to be in that.
We absolutely do not want to be in that peak surge, and we need to put ourselves in position.
Florida landfall in less than 30 hours.
Which means front right of the track.
Oh, lovely.
Storm intensifies as much as it possibly could, and
we don't watch too much of this. People get icky in head. What do you mean, icky in the head? You know what, guys? I'm going to tell you something. Do you know who's in control of all of this? Do you know the answer to that? What's the answer? Tell me. Who's in control of all of this right now? Who is it? Who is it, chap? It's God. God is actually in control of all of this. So, amen. Amen. Okay? So at the end of the day, I understand it's scary. I understand that, you know, people have suffered through these, which I don't know because I haven't been through it. I don't watch the news, so I'm not aware of these type of things. But it's sad, okay? It's very sad. It's very scary, okay? I'm not dismissing that. And I'm not dismissing all of you guys having feelings for it, PTSD, anything like that. I'm not dismissing that. What I'm trying to say is that sometimes in life, you can't control things, but you can give it to God and let Him control it. And but you can still protect yourself. You have to. You should, right? But, you know, you just sit back and you let Him take care of it. Just let Him. Just be like, okay, it's all you. You know, still. You know, yeah, there are things that you can do. Yes, absolutely, there's things that you can do. You can get yourself prepared. Absolutely, you can. I'm not telling you don't. But the fear, everything, you know, don't have fear, you know. It's okay to be scared, but just give it to God. It's in God's hands. He can control this like this. He can stop the hurricane like this.
Not putting yourself in that danger
as well.
He can.
You know, as far
he can stop it.
Clock advisory, it's just, you know, we're waiting.
Telling you, he can.
From the National Hurricane Center, that's going to be coming in likely any minute right now. And I wouldn't be surprised if we see some
just saying. This.
Yeah, Jane, we'll see. We'll get that complete update from the National Hurricane Center.
It's in God's hands. It is. 100%. Guys, I'm going to tell you guys something. I'm not going to lie, okay? But you guys know how I've been having knee problems, like knee issues? Well, it's my right knee. And, like, I really think something is going on with it. I don't really know. I have to go see a primary care doctor. They're going to have to run an MRI on my knee. They're going to have to. Yeah, they're going to have to.
Which means
our squishy earth and bodies don't matter. Our soul will live on forever. Just pray God has you. Amen. That's it. That's it. Yeah. I just give it to God. I really give it to God. I don't really. I mean, don't get me wrong. Am I scared in some way, shape, or form? Then why won't God stop the hurricane? Well, you have your own opinions, okay? But I believe in my faith. I believe in the power of God. I do. So, I'm just saying like he's in control of everything. He's in control when you pass away. He's in control of what happens to you. He knows every hair on your body. He knows exactly when you're going to die. He knows exactly what you're going to do in 5 minutes. Did you know that? Think about that for a second. Sit on that for a second. God knows exactly where your life is going to go, what's going to happen to your life, what's going to happen to your home or everything like that. He knows everything about you. Just saying. Then why does he let kids get hurt? What do you mean? Oh my gosh. Ugh. Read the Bible. I don't know. He knows. I don't. I don't think God gave your sister that. I don't. His disciples wrote it. God does not punish. He doesn't. And I'm very sorry your sister's going through that. But please don't blame that on God. Please don't blame that on him. That's something that, please, out of respect, don't. God does not look at you and be like, oh, well, magically I'm just going to make this happen so your life can go whatever. No, he doesn't do that. Now the devil will, but not God. Don't. Oh, my word. Okay, listen, at the end of the day, everybody has different religions. Everybody has different beliefs, okay? All right? God is in control of everything. He is. I'm sorry. If you don't agree with me, then that's on you. But I'm sorry. I believe he's in control. I believe everything is a part of him. 100%. Who created the heavens and the earth? Who did that? Who? Ask me. Who created the earth? Who? Tell me. Who created this earth? Who created this earth? Oh, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The devil runs this world. But that's why God says, I'm going to come back on a white horse in a blink of an eye when Gabriel sounds that trumpet. Boom, there it is. So God is coming back to call all his children home. So the devil, right? The devil was a beautiful angel, right? Beautiful angel, okay? Call him Lucifer, right? But when he did what he did, God shunned him and he got put down in hell. He's like, if you think you can run this earth better than I can, then go ahead and do it. And he got kicked out of heaven and thrown down to the pits of hell. Did you know that? So yeah, you're right. God is in control of everything. He is. Absolutely he is. That's my faith. That's my belief. Sorry, you can say whatever you want to say, but he's in control. End the conversation. Thank you. That's fine. Everyone has different beliefs. Okay, that's fine. You have your belief and I have my beliefs. That's my faith. My faith is with my God. That's it. Bottom line. You can disagree with me. That's fine. It's faith. Oh, my word. Whatever. Moving on, guys. Moving on. Is why I don't talk about stuff like that, to keep it personal, keep it private. Okay, chat, stop. Ah, you're learning. Good job, you're learning. You're learning. All right. Good job. I'm so proud of you. So proud of you, little cubbies. This is her platform to talk about what she wants to. Why does she have to hide it? Good point. You don't like it? There's the door. I'll show you the way out. Okay. Got it. I'm glad we got that taken care of. Okay. You guys are amazing. Whew, wipe that off. Not one person said she has to hide it. Okay, we're done. Okay. Okay. Alrighty. Okay. Anywho. Pizza sounds good. I'm not gonna lie. Pizza sounds really good, actually. As a Christian, we are supposed to encourage Christ, not hate on those that don't believe. Amen. And as Christians, we are supposed to walk with God and share his testimony and share that he is real. That's what Christians should do. Okay? Spread the word. Yes. Yep. That's true. Hi, Mama Bear. It's me, little Covey. Oh, hi. right. How was your day? Was your day good? You're a little cubby. You little cutie patootie. All right. Oh. Just Like Heaven Is For Real. Did you watch that movie? People die and go to heaven, come back to real life to share his testimony. Think about that for a second. Burpo. Todd Burpo? Read about him. He came back and shared what he saw in heaven. A lot of people. Just saying. But anyway, I'm done with the conversation. Just saying that. I'm just saying. Just I have my own religion, like, you know, my own beliefs on what I believe in. What? Let's order a pizza. No. You can, but I'm not going to. I can't. That's money that I don't have. Can't do that stuff. Ah, lucky. Well, I'm happy you're getting some Chinese. That sounds really good, actually. Sounds really good. I'm not gonna lie. Do you have rain boots? No, I don't. I should have gotten some, though. I'm having a brisket. What's that? So she bought her doctor that saved her the doves on that movie. Wait, what? I'm confused. I'm cooking pork tenderloin, potatoes, and corn on the cob. Oh, my, can I come? Can you bring me a plate? Hand me a plate. Can you hand me a plate, Kaylee? Thank you. With all the rain, you might see an alligator, Danny. I ain't gonna see no alligator. That no alligator's gonna come up in here. I swear if the rain and the water pushes an alligator through this dang door, I swear on my life. Okay? I swear I will lose my shit. These alligators, like, flying all over the place because of stupid-ass wind, man. No, they can stay in the water. They can stay in there. But you know what? All these alligators are going to be walking all over Florida. Not in your house. I mean, with all the water coming in, silly. Oh! Well, oh yeah, water rises and they coming to your door. What? You lying. Man, you lying. Don't do your girl like that. Wait. Yeah. Alligators can stay in that damn pond and you don't come out here. You stay in there because that's where your ass belongs. Stay in that water. You ain't coming out of that water. Come over here. No, that's not what you're thinking. Danny, you always make me smile. I needed this. Such a rough day. Jessica, I got you, girl. I got you. You know they climb fences. Oh, I know they climb fences, but I'm telling you, you don't have to climb over here to get to me. You can stay in that lake and climb the water. Do what you got to do in that water. I don't know if you got a playground in there. I don't know if you got a slide down there, but you know what? Build your own dang playground down there, okay? You want to go rock climbing? Then you build a rock climbing there. And you can climb over that thing, okay? Thank you. I said it. I'm done. Thank you. You get it? Good. I'm glad. Awesome. Perfect. Okay. But when your yard becomes the lake, well, I'm gonna tell you something, okay? These little alligators thinking that they own Florida, but they don't. I don't want to see one. I don't want to even hear one. They can stay far away from me. Isn't there a pond right outside? Oh, yes, there is. Oh, yeah, it's a beautiful pond, too. Wrongo. Wrongo. Just say inside, girl. I think that's my best choice. Yeah. Can you imagine during this hurricane, okay, walking outside to my car to grab something in my car, and there's an alligator right around the corner, okay? And it's like looking at me. I'm looking at that thing right now. That thing just opens up his mouth and say, oh, I can smell your blood from a mile away. And go chop, 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 chop. Here I come. Smack. Bye-bye. You gone. Hell no. Dude, I'd be running like so fast. I can't even tell you. I'd be like skidding right now. Like skeet, skeet. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's coming east of me. We're prepared for it. Well, good luck. Stay safe. Better run. I will run. They are really fast. They'll probably catch me with my chunkiness. can you imagine me running down the street, having an alligator behind me, running after my ass like chomp, 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 like Peter Pan, like I'm coming. I am coming. Don't go playing in floods waters. Well, Peter Pan, you gotta fly. Where's my Tinkerbell? Poof! Ah, there it is. Body slam it, Danny. Bam! I pick that sucker up and go, boom! You like that? I'll give it to you again. Oh, man. Wrestle it. Put a rope around it. Come here, I'm gonna get you. And then just like grab it and then like just take them and just go pound. You know what I'm saying? Just hold them down with his mouth open like that. You know, just go like this and like just grab them with his mouth open like this. And he's got some rope in. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yep. And I'll put him in the trash can where he belongs. And then I'll drag him all the way to a pond and I'll throw his little green ass alligator tail in the pond. That's exactly what I would do. What if a snake comes to pay you a visit? My ass would be running out the damn door. You hear me? All right. My ass would be like, bye-bye. They heavy? Oh, are they heavy? How do you even know they're heavy? Hey, Alexa, how big are alligators?
Alligators can grow to be around 500 pounds when fully grown. Female alligators are generally smaller than male alligators, while male alligators can grow to be larger than female alligators. Alligators can be found in the United States, in areas such as the Everglades, Florida, and Louisiana. They are also found in China and other parts of Asia.
Wow. 500 pounds? Well, you know what you have to say there. Rongo! Bro, 500 pounds, bro? That's heavy, bro. That's like, damn, dude. That's heavy as hell, bro. I would go to the Everglades there and feed them marshmallows. You should ask how long can they grow up to. Hey, Alexa, how long can alligators grow?
Alligators can grow to be around 19 feet 2 inches in length.
Dang, hell no, I'd be running. My ass would be past the damn door. I'd be flying like no other. I'd be Michael Jordan, you know. Boom, get on my Jordans. I'm out, bro. I'm out, dude. I'm out. Nah, no way. I'm good, thank you. I said good day. No. Rungo. 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 You jump on its back and roll with the punches. I'll be like, you know what, alligator? I'll go on my back. You go on your back. We flipper. I just can't. I love myself. I really do. Oh, man. Oh, laughter is the best medicine. I swear, y'all. I swear it is. I'd be running away. I don't like snakes either. Oh, man. They're like the poisonous snakes. Dude, like Cobra Kai, like the cobras. Man, they sketchy. They sketchy, bro. Alligators. I'm not how to spell alligator. A-G-A-L-A-G. Wait, nope. How do you spell alligator? Alligators. Does anybody know how to spell alligators? Oh, A-L-L-I-G. Oh, thank you. Thank you. I got it. Thank you. I got it. Oh, let's see. Okay. Can we see one that you wrestle with? Oh, yeah. Look it. Yeah, we are. Okay, let's... What's this one? Oh, hell no. That thing look... What the hell you doing? Oh, get him. Oh, hell no. I swear to God, you better get your ass back. What the hell is he doing? Oh, no. Oh, you know. Oh, no. Oh, my God. Yeah. Uh-huh, you better move. Oh, they're so cute. Oh, look at them. They're so cute. Look at the baby. And I'm so cute. That's so adorable. They're so little. Oh, they're so little.
Hey, guys, I'm in the Florida Everglades, and I'm looking for a 20-foot Burmese python.
Oh, zip it. Oh, you out of your dang mind. Oh, hell no. Oh, what are you doing? Oh, you can ride him? Wait, you can ride him?
60 centimeters bike area.
Wait, you can ride them? Oh, shit. Oh, wait a second. He did not just get bit. Oh, shit. Where is one? What? What are you doing?
You're my sweetest addiction.
Oh.
The driver forgot.
Thank you, Milk.
What? What? Oh, look, there's a little baby little alligators. Look at them.
Get over
Oh,
here.
Hell no.
Yeah. What you doing? Easy, fella.
Okay. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Their high school senior prank was to go to their principal's house and sleep in his yard.
What?
And
this is his... Oh. Oh.
Oh.
What the hell is this? Oh,
get her out.
Damn.
Nobody called the laws on my mic. Oh, we're going to call back in a bitch.
Nobody's crying about that. Go away, asshole.
Okay,
check
then.
Check out this precious moment.
I better be able to hear you guys.
Here we go.
How much is it for a skewer?
How many questions can you answer in 20 seconds? Go. Choose the correct spelling. Oh, T-E-A. I like this game. Choose the correct spelling. Soup. This one.
Right answer.
Okay, I like this. Choose the correct spelling. Wine. No, not that one.
What are you doing? I'm still mad at you.
This man is trying to rescue his dog from the mouth of an alligator while he was walking his pet.
Oh, I can't watch that.
Can anyone?
Oh, that's cool. What the fuck? What the fuck? Holy shit. Oh, I don't know what the hell that is.
If you feel, look at shocking, and a woman discovered a strand. Suddenly this couple noticed that the
No.
Don't move from there, you're on timeout.
Mommy put you in timeout? No one puts my little girl in timeout. I'm gonna talk to her. How long did she give you?
Something unexpected.
Anyway, whatever.
This little girl was standing near the big aquarium. Suddenly, a dolphin came up.
This black horse was brought to this man after he could barely walk, but when he took a look at the problem hoof, he was shocked. There was a whole lot of gunk and grime stuck in there with an overgrown and filthy.
I want that.
The caretaker.
What? Let's see how.
The seven most.
I can't. Whatever, this is so boring. I'm done with FYP. Oh! I don't know what's wrong with my knee. I gotta go and talk to a doctor. I gotta get myself a primary care doctor and go. But I think I'm gonna go enjoy my night, y'all, and go to bed. I'm exhausted, and I would like to relax. Oh. And watch a movie. And yeah.